Well, Hellfire, it is Rock the Riff, and we're back with some more Metalhead Heavies. And I'm diving into a band, which is actually a band that I listen to a lot. I'm a big fan of Monuments. I really liked their one album. I can never actually pronounce it without reading the title. Okay. The amanuensis. I hope that's how you're supposed to say that. The amanuensis. I really love that album. That album is one of those from track one to the ending. You just let it play. It is fucking fantastic. And the third album, I wasn't that crazy about. And my issue has been with, I'm not the biggest fan of the vocalist. He's good. He's very talented. I don't think he really fit Monuments. And I don't know, that third album, to me, it kind of seemed like he phoned it in a little bit. But there and again, there is tracks on there that are fantastic. And then I keep up with John Brown and his thing, Riff Hard. And I like his podcast and everything. But now they got this new singer, and I think his name, I know his first name is Andy, and I can't really, his last name is Sizek, I think is how you're supposed to say it. But either way, everything he has done with the Monument so far has been fucking fantastic. And I have listened to Cardinal Red backwards and forwards, but I have yet to actually check out the music video. So let's dive on in. So I had to give credit to Andy that I think his screams are fucking fantastic. The dude does lows, mids, highs. I mean, very versatile singer. And I am so glad he's a part of Monuments. And then one thing I can already say about this track that I really dig is it felt like the drums and the drummer got to play a little bit compared to a lot of other Monument songs. It's like me and my drummer always talk about how Monuments is fantastic. It's just every song is so on the downbeat. And they don't, like, sometimes they don't really try a lot of new things. I think that was what our biggest issue is with the third album is every song on that third album just sounded like it was straightforward and everything's falling on the downbeat. There wasn't a crazy amount of change-ups compared to some of the other stuff they've done. I want to pause on this Facebook. Wait, did I miss it already? It's the cool, crazy thing about music videos. So much shit happens within the 5 seconds. I watched The Joker. Watched The Joker one time and said, I like the makeup. Well, what the fuck is going on? Shit. I was zoning out in the song. I love Andy's cleans in this track. Like, this dude, I think this dude is one hell of a versatile singer. Better throat.
There's no escape from the sky. We are. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. That dude. God, Andy is such a perfect fit for this band. Because to me, John Brown tends to write very like chunky, downward picking riffs. I mean, that's his whole... If you go check out Riff Hard, which is a very cool podcast, and then I haven't dived too much into the actual lessons and all that. I think it's like a full 360 experience for guitarists and stuff. And I haven't dived into that aspect of it, but I like the podcast and I like hearing some of the people they interview. It's like they've interviewed... Which ones have I listened to? I really like the Charles Caswell one from Caswell from Buried Alive. And then I really was fascinated with, what is his name? He used to play for Rings and he plays for Interloper now. His name's Miles Dimitri or something. I can't remember his last name right now, but that was a very cool interview. And then all the guys from Periphery, those are really great interviews too. But back to Andy being part of Monuments Now, he just fits this to a T. Like, I like his versatility, and then when it's time for the riff to really be down and groovy and chunky, he fucking brings in those lows that are just very, very fucking low. It's almost my favorite part of this whole song. I don't really understand what the fuck's going on in the actual artistic side of the music video. I like seeing the full band play. I think that's really cool. And then even the imagery and all this shit part of the Cardinal side of this is cool. I just have no clue what the fuck is going on. Like some blood ritual. Yeah, rub it in, baby. That's best for the hair growth. So I'm assuming it's like a blood cult. But I don't understand. So I like that fucking evil cathedral, church organ. I think that's cool. I'm gonna get a close up of these people smiling again. Yeah, that's the full band. I like that. Yeah. At the time of me recording this, I get to listen to the newest single. What is it called? it is False Providence featuring Mick Gordon. Is Mick Gordon throughout this whole album? Because it says he's featured on this song too, which is pretty cool. If Mick Gordon joins Monuments, that's actually kind of a good fit, because he's all about the dark, downpick groove kind of style too, as John. But I picked this one because I was getting ready to listen to False Providence here in a little bit when I leave to go do some personal stuff. And plus, Monuments needs as much attention as they can get because they are fucking fantastic. I don't understand why they're not a bit of a bigger band. But at the same time, I mean, it's not everybody's cup of tea. It's my cup of tea. It's a big cup of tea that I would drink every day. Big old cup of sweet tea. And yeah, music video production's good. I will say part of the reason why I do like Monuments is how well produced their stuff is. Like, the drums always sound so good, and I always wonder if they're programmed or recorded live. I'm not sure in that aspect. And I think the only complaint I can give about this song is there's no guitar solo. Every metal song deserves a guitar solo at some point, in my opinion. There always should be a guitar solo. And with that being said, I'll catch y'all in the next one. So stay positive, stay rocking, and I'm out.